Now, I take the privilege of introducing Swami Atmashraddhanandji Maharaj, who has been the supporting pillar and guiding light of VSC for the past 10 years. He currently edits Vedant Kesari, a cultural and health spiritual monthly, which is in its 100th year of publication. He has authored and edited few books in English, which include Bhagavad Gita for students, Upanishads for students, Universal Prayers for youth, Indian culture, its ageless charm and timeless appeal, Vivekananda tells stories, and few others. He has addressed various groups consisting of students, teachers, and others in places such as Pune, Nagpur, Bangalore, Mysore, Mumbai, Jammu, Vadodara, Chandigarh, Kolkata, and Delhi. He has been delivering talks in our Sunday classes for the past 10 years. His continued guidance and association with VSC has been our vital strength. Now, without making any further delay, I request Swami Atmashraddhanandji Maharaj to deliver the welcome address.
Dear Vinayak Lohani, Sri Narayan Swami, esteemed faculty members, invited guests, revered Swami Satyagyananji and other monastic brothers in the audience, and my very dear young friends, both freshers as well as the older ones. Namaskars, and on behalf of Vivekananda Study Circle, I extend a warm welcome to everyone to our 18th annual inaugural function. On behalf of all the volunteers, past, present, and of course future, on behalf of everyone who has been helping us in many ways in all these years, I extend a warm and cordial welcome to this annual event, which marks the beginning of our activities for the academic year 2014 and 15. We have gathered here to be part of yet another year of activities centering around the life-giving, man-making, character-building message of Swami Vivekananda, which has inspired millions of people the world over. Just recently was concluded the 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, which is observed in all parts of the world, all parts of India. And we at IIT, at VSC too, had our share, our great privilege of organizing activities and events in that context. It's a delight to welcome all present here, most of whom are young, intelligent, and noble, the finest of our youth in India. To be young is a privilege. It's a privilege to be young and to dream of a great life, a life of success, of recognition, of contribution to the society, of joy and fulfillment. The Taittiriya Upanishad speaks of a young man, Yuvasyat Sadhu Yuva Adhyayakaha Ashishto Dradishta Balishtaha. A young man, noble and learned, strong in every way, physically, intellectually, morally, such a man is fit to pursue life in a meaningful way. Energy and enthusiasm are the hallmark of youth, along with freshness of a youthful body and mind. Such a youth is indeed a privileged section of the society. But being young itself is not sufficient. One should also be rightly directed. It is not sufficient to work hard, but it is also important in which direction is our hard work directed or is going to. Youth is a golden period of life, no doubt. But then unless it is well utilized, well directed, it can also become a dark phase of life. Essentially, the youth energy is like a mass of energy. It has to be channeled. Like a dam across a river, we have to channel it. Water in itself looks just like any other liquid matter. But when millions of gallons of water rush through a river unchecked, it can cause widespread devastation. It may look simple, but water has tremendous energy. As you know, it is the potential energy which becomes kinetic energy and does all the wonder, good or bad. Recently, I had the occasion to visit Sardar Sarovar Dam across Narmada River near Vadodara in Gujarat. You know, it's a massive river valley project, one of the largest in Asia. What an inspiring place it was. Next to the dam is located the hydro power generation unit. There are large turbines there which rotate through the power of flowing waters and produce so many megawatts of electricity, which is supplied to hundreds of towns and villages across three states in India. This electricity generation is a fine example of how human energies can be or should be channeled. Swami Vivekananda said, no power can be created, but it can be directed. Human beings have tremendous power, and in youth, this power is at its peak, at its best. We must tame it, check it, and channel it in truly fruitful and productive channels. And that would produce the power of goodness and love, which will light up our lives and lives of others. Swami Vivekananda spoke of renunciation and service as the national ideals of India. What does that mean? Swamiji explained renunciation in the following way. He said, renounce the lower so that you may get the higher. What is the foundation of society? Morality, ethics, laws. Renounce. Renounce the all temptation to take your neighbor's property, to put hands upon your neighbor, all the pleasure of tyrannizing over the weak, all the pleasure of cheating others by telling lies. Is not morality the foundation of society? He further said, sacrifice, give up, not for zero, not for nothing, but to get the higher. But who can do this? You cannot until you have got the higher. You may talk, you may struggle, you may try to do many things, but renunciation comes by itself when you have got the higher. Then the lesser will fall away by itself. This is practical religion. So giving up the lower for the higher, that is renunciation. Not running away from the society, but by contributing to society through giving up our self-centeredness and living a life devoted to a higher ideal of living. The motto of Vivekananda Study Circle, as Sai Tej has also pointed out, is nation building through character building. In other words, if you want to build nation, build and prepare individuals with noble character. Nation does not mean only improving our infrastructure to have more materialistic progress. This is necessary, needed, but what is more needed is the molding of right kind of human beings. This is the need of a nation, an organization, of a company, of a school or a college or a house. In fact, every department of life. What we need is the right kind of human beings. We should focus on man-making, which is what will lead to right type of nation-making or nation-building. Character-building means building up our lives, our personalities, our behavior, our priorities in life, everything on the twin principles of self-control and unselfishness. For this, one should take care of what one thinks, what one feels, what one sees and hears, or likes to see and hear. In the famous Vedic prayer, one says, may we hear what is auspicious, and may we hear what is auspicious. We must be on our guard. Character is built little by little, by our thoughts, by our actions in day-to-day life. You may recall the part of the quotation which is put on the calendar, which is distributed to all the people this time, all the freshers and the newcomers this time. The full passage of that quote is this. Swamiji says, this is a quotation from Swamiji. He says, if you want to judge of the character of a man, look not at his great performances. Every fool may become a hero at one time or another. Watch a man do his most common actions. Those are indeed the things which will tell you the real character of a great man. Great occasions rouse the lowest of human beings to some kind of greatness. But he alone is the really great man whose character is great always, the same wherever he may be. So let us begin by changing ourselves, and then can we have the right to change others. Let us remember this very important fact. Now, service. Swami said there are two national ideals of India. One is renunciation and there is service. Service is an outcome of character. The sum total of all character or goodness lies in our willingness to do some good to others. Swami Vivekananda rightly said, in the world, take always the position of the giver. Give everything and look for no return. Give love, give help, give service, give any little thing you can, but keep out the barter. Make no conditions and none will be imposed. To sum up, sacrificing the lower for the higher and giving to others out of goodness of heart is what constitutes the true meaning of channeling youth power. This channeling may assume many forms and names. Vinayak Lohani, who is going to shortly address us, is one such example of youth energy well channeled. Well, academic studies are important, entertainment is important, ambition is important, and many more things are important, but what is most important is man-making, developing oneself, developing one's intellectual and moral potential, and finding a true meaning in life. This is the need of the hour, the need of the country, the need of the family, the need of the individual. VSC has been committed to this ideal, and that we have been receiving a continued support from the IIT community for the past 18 years is a testimony to this noble fact. We welcome Sri Lohani, who has come all the way from Calcutta to address us, to Professor Narayan Swami, who has kindly agreed to say a few words representing the IIT faculty, and to all our invited guests, and to every student present here, we extend once again a warm and cordial welcome. Please come and join us in all our activities with enthusiasm. Namaskar.